After months of uncertainty due to COVID-19, cricket did finally resume in July, but bio bubbles seem to have become a part of professional sport. There were restrictions on movement of athletes and cricket had to incorporate interim changes. A lot of cricket had to also be suspended, but when it did return, clearly everything wasn't the same.
March 13 was the day when cricket walked into uncertainty. Just like the lives of people across the globe, cricket went into a total shutdown with questions galore and answers none.
We met with them to tell them what is the situation, how it can happen and how it can go, where do we stand at the moment, but at the moment it is just postponed. In any case, 15 days are gone. It has to be a truncated one. How truncated, how many games, I can't say at the moment.
But did this have a closed door, because probably this could be an option?
We'll see, but till April 15, nothing, because no visas, nothing.
World's biggest and most lucrative cricket league, the IPL 2, was thrown into cold storage, and the announcements of suspensions and cancellations of various tournaments began pouring in. The entire ecosystem of sport was in the clutches of COVID-19 and the world had come to a standstill. But efforts were being made and opportunities were being explored. England invited West Indies for a 3-test series which marked the resumption of international cricket. Strict guidelines were issued and the ICC made interim changes in the rules so as to avoid any hiccups. West Indies arrived in the UK a month before the first test and remained in a biosecure bubble for the entire duration of that tour.
Can't do that, Ben. Social distancing and all that.
The series marked the resumption of cricket in a world that was tentative, uncertain, and in a great deal of unrest.
We know we've got a lot of people back home and around the world watching, supporting us. It's a massive occasion for cricket, and it's just great that it's back on the TV for people to be able to watch.
While people were battling against the pandemic, West Indies and England delivered a statement to the world about the equality and the Black Lives Matter movement. Players acted, and then there were those like Michael Holding who sent out a moving and powerful message to the world.
And we need to go back and teach both sides of history. And until we do that and educate the entire human race, this thing will not stop. They keep on telling me there's nothing called white privilege. Give me a break. I don't see any white people going into a store on Oxford Street and being followed. A black man walks in, somebody's following him everywhere he goes. That is basic white privilege. Whether that white person went in to rob the place or not, is not going to be thought of that way. And things like that have to change.
We've all been looking away too long. The players should be proud of wearing these badges. We should be proud of wearing these badges. But really, 2020, we have to wear a badge saying Black Lives Matter? Really? That should be a given, Wardy.
Cricket was no longer just a sport, but also a tool to unite people. England's series against West Indies was followed by Pakistan and Australia's tour to the UK.
And the expression changes immediately. Number 600 for Jimmy Anderson.
Except for a couple of deviations or minor breaches from Jofra Archer and Mohammad Hafiz, all the three tours to England remained glitch-free, giving confidence to the authorities outside UK to organise games. By the time the West Indies series against England came to an end, the news of the suspended IPL being organised in the UAE had become official.
A couple of months ago, you could not even imagine that you'd have IPL firstly, and then things started opening up and things started getting together, and we saw other tournaments take place, so got a bit of confidence from that. Now when we had our practice session yesterday, is the time I realized how long it's been. When I was heading to the practice session, I felt nervous.
Bilateral series in a controlled environment was one thing, But to organize a tournament like IPL with 8 teams and hundreds of officials was a massive task. The start of the IPL was nothing but scary. 13 members of the Chennai Super Kings franchisee, including 2 players, tested positive for COVID-19, and the first ball of the season had not been bowled. That raised many doubts over the future of the season, and it didn't take too long for the second controversy to hit the IPL. Suresh Raina returned home in a huff, and then Harbhajan Singh also decided not to travel for the tournament in the UAE.
The wait is finally over. It is time for the 2020 of 2020.
But as soon as the first ball was bowled, everything was put aside and the cricket carnival had begun. Matches over a period of 53 days were completed without any further hiccups, giving confidence to the cricket fraternity. The success of the season gave belief to the all-powerful BCCI to plan for another season of the IPL, this time in India in 5 months' time. Soon, Team India also embarked on their first international tour in over 9 months when they reached Australia for a full-fledged tour. Sports Bureau, India Today.